What is involved in teaching medical math? Hi, I'm Jimmy Chang, and I've been teaching college math for nearly a decade, and we're here to discuss how you teach medical mathematics to high school students. Now, we're going to talk about a few topics which are involved heavily in medical math in everyday life, and the very first thing we'll talk about is a measurement, because it is probably the most important aspect, because when you're in a hospital, for example, you take a lot of measurements, whether it be saliva levels, your blood count, white and red blood count, the amount of waters in the system, how high the cholesterol happens to be. You'll be doing a lot of measurement, especially working in the more interactive aspect, whether it be, you know, as a nurse or a doctor, what have you. And so measurement is a very important aspect when teaching medical math to high school students. Dimensional analysis is also a very important aspect because you might be called upon to convert from one unit to the next. Sometimes you may be asked to convert different liquid containers, converting cups to ounces, etc. So there may be times in which the unit that you have is not enough because you may be asked to convert to other units that might be applicable to the different scenarios. And last but not least, if you're working under the business aspect of medicine, you will definitely need to teach them how to handle business mathematics because there are a lot of costs and expenses involved, and so they'll definitely be called upon sometimes to balance the books. So business math is also a very important aspect of it. So I hope we've talked about three very important topics with you on teaching medical math and mathematics, and my name is Jimmy Chang, and math is power in medicine.